been using a double click, the mouse pointer on an icon. Like that, I guess. Whoops, no, you told me to go down here. How'd that here get here? Oh, well, you circled it, so I know. Oh, twice. No. Let me read it again, see if I did something wrong there. Folders with a double click, to open using a double click, quickly click the left mouse button twice. I did, nothing happened.
Yeah, Ray, you're doing a good job there. Your mouse pointer is jumping between the clicks, though. That's why it's not working.
Oh. Boy, that's too sensitive, then. Programs. Put it inside the Word folder.
Try that again for me, Ray, if you would. Thanks.
I only hit the button once because I'd forgotten I needed to do it twice.
Microsoft Windows 95, the operating system that changed everything. Windows 3.1, released in 1992, was a significant milestone in the development of graphical user interfaces for personal computers. It offered improved user friendliness and multitasking capabilities compared to its predecessors, and quickly became a standard in the PC world. Windows 95 built on the foundations of Windows 3.1 and introduced significant improvements, including the Start button and Taskbar. It was a full 32-bit operating system that offered better performance and stability, marking the transition from the MS-DOS-based environment to a modern graphical user interface. Now, let's take a look at how Windows 95 became the system we know today. The Windows 95 build from July 20, 1992, originally mistaken for a development version of Windows for Workgroups 3.1, is the earliest confirmed version of Windows 95. It features a redesigned user interface with enhanced 3D elements and includes new applications, such as an updated file manager with right-click menus and a redesigned paintbrush application called Raster. This build also introduces early versions of the task list and control panel changes. However, it lacks Win32 support and requires MS-DOS to be pre-installed. The build is notable for its similarities to Windows for Workgroups 3.1 and includes several bugs, particularly in networking and MS-DOS application support. Build 58S of Windows 95 introduced several significant changes and new features. One of the most notable additions is the prototype of the Start menu, which initially divided its functions into three separate buttons. Unlike in later builds, the taskbar served as a folder for storing shortcuts, files, and folders, not for displaying running applications. This build also introduced the file cabinet, a new file manager that remained relatively unchanged in subsequent versions. Additionally, Build 58S included support for long file names and native right-click functionality, which were absent in Windows 3.1. Since Build 58S, Windows 95 Build 73F has undergone several significant changes. The setup process has been massively overhauled, with new backgrounds, a non-disclosure agreement, and improved customization options. The taskbar has been redesigned to display running applications, more like the modern taskbar, and no longer functions as a folder by default. A new briefcase feature has been introduced, which is meant to sync files between itself and another folder. Many aspects of Windows have been ported to 32-bit, including the cabinet shell. Additionally, the control panel has been redesigned, merging several applets and introducing new ones for features like telephony and network security. Application features have also been updated with the introduction of WritePad and the phone dialer. The build also includes a safe to shutdown screen, previously only present in the NT branch of Windows. Build 90C includes an application for playing CD audio, although it may fail to load due to memory constraints. Additionally, the games folder was moved inside the accessories folder. The setup process has been enhanced with an option to recover from crashes, which later evolved into smart recovery and then into safe recovery. A fun find in the setup process is that this is the only known build mentioning Windows 94. This is interesting because the earliest known build using the Windows 95 branding was build 188, which was compiled 6 months later. Windows 95 build 99 introduced several notable changes and new features. This build includes an updated boot screen and new icons, along with native ATABI CD-ROM support. The network applet was updated to allow configuration of network card settings during setup. Advanced settings now offer a Windows 3.1 compatibility mode and the option to force 32-bit drivers for improved performance. Additionally, the emergency boot disk was renamed to startup disk. However, this build is not without its issues. It won't boot on processors higher than an Intel Pentium, and several video cards can't use true color or high color at higher resolutions because of insufficient memory. Build 122, known as Beta 1, removed the parasailing boat test video present in earlier builds and updated various system files, including the fax viewer and NetWare client files. Even though not much was changed from previous builds, it nevertheless has some bugs, including the control panel not working in fail-safe mode and audio distortions with Sound Blaster 16. Since build 122, Windows 95 has undergone significant changes by build 189. Build 189, also known as Beta 1.4, introduced new branding and a revamped user interface that closely resembles the final version of Windows 95. Notable updates include the renaming of features such as Check Hard Disk to Scan Disk and the introduction of support for the Win key on the keyboard. Additionally, Build 189 is the earliest available build to use the new Windows 95 branding, marking a significant milestone in the development of the operating system. Build 216, a Beta 2 release candidate, featured a redesigned scan disk tool and updated UI elements, enhancing the overall user interface. For example, the start menu received a new banner, and the close, minimize, maximize, and help buttons were updated. The waste basket was renamed to recycle bin, and the MS-DOS prompt was changed to report the version as Microsoft Windows 95. One notable addition was the introduction of billboards during the setup process, which showcased some of the new features of Windows 95. However, Build 216 also included a time bomb mechanism that triggered a system shutdown after a certain period. Build 222 of Windows 95, part of Beta 2, introduced several changes and new features compared to Build 216. One notable update in Build 222 is the availability of the operating system in multiple languages, including Dutch, French, German, Italian, Spanish, and Swedish. This build features partial localization of the user interface, with some elements not fully translated across all languages. Additionally, The German variant includes unique branding and a distinct setup BMP background image. Build 222 also incorporates the metric system for certain measurements, such as floppy drive sizes in some language variants. Since Build 222, Windows 95 has undergone several minor tweaks leading up to Build 310. For example, WinPad has been discontinued and is no longer included since Build 285. In Build 275, a new "Please wait while your computer is shutting down" screen was introduced, replacing the dialog box used in previous builds. Build 310 is the last build that requires a beta site ID and password to install. It features a new boot screen that reads "Test Release January 95" with a color cycling Windows logo next to it. Between Windows 95 Build 310 and Build 347, several significant changes and updates were introduced. Build 347, also known as the final beta, was part of a large-scale beta test and included multilingual support. Build 311 was the first build to run ScanDisk before starting setup, and Build 314 was the first build that did not use a desktop wallpaper by default. In Build 323, the non-disclosure agreement was removed from the setup process, and it included the Microsoft network, along with an icon on the desktop. Build 337 introduced a new boot screen that was closer to the final screen, saying "Windows 95 Final Beta Release." Also, the Microsoft network icon was updated to look more final. In Build 342, a software license agreement was added to the setup process. Its boot screen was altered to replace the black frame with a gray bar with blue arrows pointing to the Windows logo. Windows 95 Build 420 has introduced several notable changes. This build now mandates an upgrade from an older version, removing the option for a clean install. A new batch script has been included to allow the creation of floppy installation media. Additionally, the printer test page now features the Windows 95 logo instead of the older Windows 3.1 era logo. Since Build 405, the shutdown screen received its nearly final design, and the time bomb was removed before it was reintroduced in the first release candidate, Build 490. Later builds all work towards the release of Microsoft Windows 95.
It used to be difficult for personal computers to do more than one thing at a time. Starting with Windows 95, it's easy. Start multitasking. Start Windows 95.
Here it is, the retail version of Windows 95, released on August 24th, 1995. The launch was a monumental event. Microsoft spared no expense in promoting the new operating system, with a campaign that included television commercials, print ads, and a highly publicized launch event. The marketing strategy emphasized the user-friendly interface, the integration of the internet, and the overall enhanced computing experience. The iconic "Start Me Up" campaign, featuring the Rolling Stones song, became synonymous with the Windows 95 launch and helped generate immense public interest and excitement. The retail version was made available in stores worldwide, accompanied by extensive media coverage and promotional events, making it one of the most successful product launches in the history of the software industry. OEM Service Release 1, or Windows 95A, is an updated version of Windows 95 that was released in February 1996. It includes several small improvements and fixes that were not present in the original release and ships with Internet Explorer 2.0. Released in August 1996, OSR2, also known as Windows 95B, included new drivers for enhanced hardware support. It also introduced the FAT32 file system, which provided more efficient disk space utilization and support for larger hard drives compared to the previous FAT16 system. Additionally, OSR2 came with Internet Explorer 3.0, improving internet browsing capabilities and integration with the operating system. Another update, OSR 2.1, added USB support, which allowed for easier connection of peripherals and support for AGP cards. OSR 2.5, or Windows 95C, which was released in November 1997, was notable for featuring the Windows Desktop Update. It made several changes to Windows Explorer to integrate it with Internet Explorer 4.0, very similar to the version that was later shipped with Windows 98. It added Active Desktop, the Active Channels bar, the Quick Launch bar, web folders, folder customization, an improved start menu, and support for displaying thumbnail image previews in Windows Explorer. In the mid-1990s, Windows 95 was not initially seen as a viable gaming platform due to its lack of features available in MS-DOS, such as direct hardware access. To address this, Microsoft developed DirectX, a collection of APIs designed to provide high-performance multimedia capabilities. The first version of DirectX was released in September 1995, aiming to make Windows 95 more attractive to game developers. To demonstrate its capabilities and encourage adoption, Microsoft collaborated with id Software to port Doom to Windows 95, resulting in Doom 95. This port was significant as it showcased the potential of DirectX for game development and was heavily promoted, including advertisements featuring Bill Gates.
These games are getting really realistic. Next year I might even play in the big Doom tournament. You might wonder what I'm doing here. Well, I'm getting kind of an inside look at some of these new games. I think you'll be amazed at all the new games we're going to show you here this evening. We've got a few key points to remember. First, Windows 95 is the game platform. Whether it's the best performance, the best setup, the best integration, with the toolkits we're putting together, we're going to make sure people are very focused on Windows 95. DOS. It's been impossible to install the games. Hard for the developers, hard for the users, tough support problems, and nowhere near the graphics performance we're getting today with our DirectX APIs. A second key point is that we think the PC really is the entertainment platform for the future. We're going to have the best performance, the way to reach out and do multiplayer games, lots of new peripherals, and the improvements just keep coming. Our commitment is to make the tools, to make the platform better and better.
Yeah.
Don't interrupt me. And a third point is I really want to thank all the third parties who've made this possible. The reaction of the game community has been fantastic. I will be showing you here 75 new games, all of which will be coming out by the end of the year. We really believe that with their help, we'll be able to clean up this DOS mess and get everything focused on Windows. And it's our commitment to keep moving ahead and doing that. Well, I better go work on cleaning up this neighborhood here. So I'm off. But don't forget, when you're trying out our haunted house, don't lose your head. See ya.
The success of Doom 95 helped establish DirectX as a key technology for gaming on Windows platforms. DirectX 2.0 became a built-in component of Windows with the release of Windows 95 OSR 2. Windows 95 didn't just change the way we use computers. It changed the way we lived, setting the stage for the digital revolution that would follow. Thank you for joining us on this journey through the history of Windows 95. We hope you enjoyed this look back at a pivotal moment in technology. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time.